NBA Youngboy is known by a large number of people not only for his tracks but also for his legal issues. Youngboy is not an easygoing individual from his legal records and his feuds with other rappers. Youngboy doesn't care what others finna feel about him, he doesn't care about the steps his ops finna take against him. He makes live videos calling out names of those he has problems with in real time.
Before we start the video, make sure to leave a like, and if you would like to join this month's giveaway of one of these items on the screen, then all you have to do is subscribe to the channel and watch this video to the end to comment the hidden keyword. Good luck!
Several rappers have had their share of the never-ending street violence. Many have been shot, while many are dead. However, a large number of those deaths have been linked to one feud or the other. Some rappers have been apprehended in connection to some shootings, while some were just allegedly based on one ongoing feud or the other, and NBA Youngboy is not exempted. Also, NBA Youngboy has had his share of the street violence he's alleged a part of, which has raised a few questions. There's been a lot of speculation too concerning the shooting that involved Youngboy. A lot of people believe it has something to do with those NBA Youngboy has attacked in the past. And now I'll tell you about the rappers that are allegedly killed by NBA Youngboy. Though Youngboy has never been seen or arrested for shooting anyone, it doesn't mean he's not connected to some deaths, right? Killing people without pointing a gun at them is possible because sometimes those who use the guns are ordered by someone else. As you know, Youngboy is one of the top street guys who have a lot of goons who are willing to do their dirty jobs for them. So you can never tell. Before I continue, remember that some of the information provided in this video is alleged and not confirmed. Alright, let's move on. Recently, NBA Lil Pap was arrested. You might have seen that in the news already. And now you're wondering how that's Youngboy's concern. I'll tell you all about it. Lil Pap was indicted on second-degree murder charges for his role in the 2017 shooting of rival TPG rapper G-Money. Lil Pap, named DeAndre Fields, allegedly shot and killed G-Money, named Garrett Burton, in a parking lot outside Burton's recording studio in September of 2017. And 2 years later, NBA Lil Pap was arrested on murder charges. An arrest warrant detailed how G-Money released a track dissing Youngboy's sister, and Youngboy responded in a social media post to escalate tensions between the crews. Youngboy was never finna take that from anyone, and you can trust him to attack G-Money on social media. So in the days before G-Money's death, NBA Youngboy made several social media posts about G-Money in which G-Money never failed to respond to. Through his posts, none of them was ready to let go or stop for the other. This further exacerbated tensions between the two rival music groups. After a few days, G-Money was murdered. Immediately, the news of his death was released. Members of the NBA group automatically became suspects of that case, because of the ongoing rap music feud between NBA members and G-Money's crew. The feud between NBA Youngboy and G-Money aside, Lil Pap, who was a suspect of the crime already, shot himself in the leg while in an interview with police, which made it more suspicious. When Pap was interviewed by police in days following the murder, Pap said he was not in any way involved with G-Money's death, like he was not in any way close to what happened to G-Money. He claimed that he was in Hyman, Louisiana, and he was even traveling with his mother and son to New Roads, Louisiana, after G-Money died because he was scared of retaliation. But when Pap's phone was investigated, police discovered Pap's phone records didn't match up with his story since he was actually in Baton Rouge the night of Burton's death. So Lil Pap got himself into trouble and faces life in prison if he's convicted on second-degree murder charges. Youngboy's attorney, James Manasseh, believes his client didn't have any connection to Burton's murder. He said, "As far as I know, there's never been any insinuation that Cantrell had any involvement in this situation. Like I said earlier, most of the time, guys like Youngboy don't do the dirty jobs by themselves. They order others who are willing to do the job and also take the blame for it if anything goes wrong." This is not to say that Youngboy ordered the hit, but just think about the whole situation. Why did G-Money die after dissing Youngboy's sister? Why was NBA Lil Pap, who was an associate of Youngboy, arrested for the crime? And why did Pap have to lie about his location on the day G-Money died? Just think about it and let me know what you think in the comment section. As for me, I think those are the reasons why NBA Youngboy is the alleged killer of G-Money. Next is the rapper whose death shook the streets, King Von. You know the gist of when King Von died and how he died, but in case you forgot, and also be able to understand my story, I'll remind you. King Von was killed in 2020 after getting into an altercation with Quando Rondo, and there's a clip that shows a bit of what happened that night, but a lot of people have reacted and said a whole lot of things about the incident. According to the clip, one thing is clear, there was a fight between Rondo and Vaughn, but it was Vaughn that kept holding Quando Rondo while Rondo was moving backward, as if retreating before Timothy Leeks, known as Lil' Tim, fired shots at King Vaughn, which eventually took his life. Remember that Quando is a close associate of NBA Youngboy, and Lil' Tim is a very close friend of Quando Rondo. So it's clear to some extent why Tim shot Vaughn, who was fighting with his friend. Though Tim was arrested for the charge, it is somehow linked to Youngboy never broke again. Before Vaughn's death, he had issues with NBA Youngboy, and it all started when Vaughn was listening to Youngboy's song while doing a live video, and he started talking about NBA Youngboy's song rudely. He was asking others who were there with him, what's he talking about, referring to Youngboy. Though Youngboy didn't take any rash action because they were both being watched by the police for the legal issues, and they know that any silly move would land him in jail. So nothing was heard from Youngboy for a while, and it was as if nothing happened. But you know that can never be true, both sides were just waiting for their chances. And then something I believe must have fueled the feud happened. It was King Vaughn again this time. King Vaughn was allegedly having a relationship with NBA Youngboy's ex-girlfriend and baby mama. They've both been captured and posted on social media, and that raised eyebrows. A lot of comments from people must have angered NBA the most. You know how we can be in every comment section. So Vaughn was asked in an interview if he was truly dating Mitchell, Youngboy's baby mama, but Vaughn denied, saying they were only making music together and nothing more. King Vaughn's claims would have been believed and not for the type of person King Vaughn was. Vaughn was someone who would do something silly just to get in his rival's heads. He's not on good terms with Youngboy, and the next thing is to play around with his baby mama? Come on, it looks more like he's trying to get to Youngboy than just making music. If NBA Youngboy's ex-girlfriend was going out with someone else, it might not be a problem for Youngboy because they were both no longer together at the time. The fact that it was a relationship with someone who appeared to be against Youngboy caused a problem that involved not only Youngboy but also other members of NBA and close friends of Youngboy. Then Quando Rondo began to diss King Vaughn. The feud went on until King Vaughn was murdered by Lil' Tim. Alright guys, what do you think about this story of NBA Youngboy and the rappers he allegedly killed? If there's another rapper you think should be on the list, add it in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, kindly give it a thumbs up and also share it with others. Also, if you would like to see more videos like this, all you need to do is subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell to get notified of more interesting content, just like this as they drop on this channel. See y'all in the next one, we out!
Hey you, yeah you, you like the video? Great, we got another one for you that we guarantee you'll like. And all you have to do is click on the screen. It's free and without any hidden fees, but you have to click on fast because this message will self-destruct in 5 seconds.